Greetings and ciao, Apostoli del Benessere de Bianchi, Apostles for White Well-Being, Della Ninja Azzurro, the Blue Ninja, yours truly. Saturday, July 8th, morning. Hope everyone's doing well. All my warmest and best, as always. And 1 second. Boy, some of these places really do like to bother you. Even on the early side. Ogden, Utah at the moment, heading up to Idaho, where I hope to stay a little bit longer. One of the last places where we can find people of our kind of sane mind, heart, and spirit, as a lot of us know. Gonna try to give the traveling a break for a little bit. But I just wanted to briefly follow up on one thing from yesterday, and then a couple more things. So first of all, talking about my baby boomer friend, one of them yesterday, the one that I wrote the email to, the long one, and I've written emails like that to him before, about anti-whiteism, white well-being, and so forth. And as he has done before, he just responds with anti-white propaganda from his youth, mainly the World War II era. And as I said, he basically kind of ignores what I tell him about anti-whiteism and so forth. And then just anti-white narrative is all he wants to give me. And I just forgot to mention a little tidbit that he did give me another bit of the anti-white narrative that in response to my recent email yet again. So it just seemed like he was just ignoring it. Responded to the other things that were not about that. But then sent me some clip from some show, I guess, some movie or something on Netflix, which is guaranteed to be anti-white. I couldn't even watch it because I don't have Netflix. Thank God. But it was called The Railway Man. And it was supposedly about a soldier from World War II after the war who was shattered, obviously, you know, shaken up after the war and unexpectedly fell in love with a woman. And there was a love story there. And that was the caption on the movie or the show or whatever. It was basically just that. But you know, I already know without looking at any clips or anything, that it's going to be loaded with anti-white narrative from World War II. That's the framework of all that stuff. And most people just accept that as a given, just like in the Matrix, people just accept the Matrix as a given. This is just life. This is just how things are. Not realizing it's all a fantasy world. So you already know, even if it's not explicitly in the title, in the description, something radically, heinously anti-white, if it's about any bits of the anti-white narrative like that, especially World War II, a big one, you know it's going to be loaded with heavy, heavy anti-whiteism. And so, you know, you could just imagine a soldier, a story is going to be about a soldier, even if it's after the war, it's going to be just, you know, all about this soldier and all the hard things he went through in war, the bad things he saw. And of course, those hard things, those bad things in anti-white movies like that are always going to be the horrors of blah blah blah. And it's going to be anti-white narrative. And my friend just said, thank God none of us had to go through that. You know, at that World War II, all that stuff. And, you know, it's just the ultimate point about it is it just makes you realize, makes me realize that so many baby boomers like him are still living in that narrative from that time, from their youth, when they were very young, or maybe even before they were born, you know, growing up with all that propaganda. They're still to this day living in that, taking in all the propaganda, still to this day, kind of romanticizing it, even though they say, oh, it was so bad. But they're stuck on that whole narrative. That's their world. It's all based on this crazy war, World War II, and it's all about, you know, white men of a certain country mainly being the bad guys, who in reality are heroes. And it's all about, wow, it was so horrible. Whites were the bad guys, basically. It was whites fighting whites. Horrible in every way. And people that were in the war are thankful that they lived through it, if they did. But mostly the baby boomers were not in that war, their parents were. So the baby boomers are just had all that propaganda, though. They had the heaviest doses of the propaganda. The stories that were told after, which have basically nothing to do with reality, in my opinion. And so they were just living in that story. And the story was, wow, it was horrible. Teaching them to hate whites, hate their own people. And, you know, thank God we didn't have to go through that. That's what the baby boomers grew up with. Just be thankful you didn't have to fight in World War II. Meanwhile, not realizing the most heavy attack, I think far, far, far worse than what actually happened in World War II, although that was bad. But the damage was equal, if not greater, after that, with all the psychological warfare that was just beginning and would continue to reach absolutely insane levels, not realizing they were being bombarded. They were in a war like none other, equal to or worse than the real physical war of World War II. These baby boomers are saying, thank God we didn't go through that, as they are were being attacked heavier than almost anyone. Sad thing about it is they still had their people. It was just laying the groundwork for the poison that would start to wreak serious damage and do away with so many of our people as we see now. They're still living in that fantasy. Still, to this day. World War II. Basing everything on World War II. And everything they were told. That's crazy. And it's anti-white. So now, the first thing is that they were victimized horribly. But what they should do is acknowledge that. What they should do is acknowledge that they were victimized. I mean, what I would say to a baby boomer is, it's not your fault, you were victimized. I'm on your side. It's just like any victim of any trauma. You know, they're gonna be angry. They might fight back or fight you, even though you're trying to help them. There's a lot of crazy reactions they have. You know, but ultimately, just like any victim of any trauma, they were victimized. And they're gonna be all out of sorts. And you know, and just like people are today, it's the same thing. But you just say, look, the ultimate thing is you were victimized. It's not your fault. And try to do things to help them. You know, and a lot of them reject this, and it's a battle, but ultimately that's the point. You baby boomers were victimized. They need to acknowledge that and try to do better. Heal themselves. You know, and it's hard for people to do that, especially them, I think, because they were so heavily indoctrinated and brainwashed and fooled. So it's, you know, it's a hit on their ego for them to admit that they were completely wrong for their entire lives, into doing something very wrong, participating in things that were wrong against their own kind. You know, but that's where you have to say, look, it's not your fault. Ultimately, you were victimized. You were led into that. You didn't have much of a choice, you know, because the power was so lopsided. So it's not your fault. Just don't beat yourself up. Just do the right thing now. Try to heal. You know, it's just like a victim of any trauma. You don't, there's no need for them to, if they blame themselves for that, it's a lot harder for them to heal. Because they're going to not want to, they're going to hang on to it and think that they're being blamed for the trauma that was done to them. You know, that so many baby boomers, they hang on to that. They've made it their own. You say, that wasn't yours. They think it was, but it wasn't yours. It was implanted into them, all the ideas they have in their heads. That was put in by outside forces against you. That's the first thing. It's not, it wasn't done by you, all those bad things. It's not your fault. You don't have to take a hit on your ego for this. And that's what obviously sets you free and helps you just do the right thing. But so many baby boomers have internalized it, that when you try to get them out of that and take them to freedom and healing, they fight you because they feel like they're admitting they were wrong, and so on and so forth. That's the mistake that I don't give any excuses for, nowadays, especially to anyone, including baby boomers. Nowadays, I give no excuses to anyone, not least baby boomers, for not recognizing anti-whiteism and not doing things that can help when they are presented with these things. I give them no excuses whatsoever. I don't care how much they were indoctrinated. Everyone was indoctrinated, every white person on planet Earth. There is no excuse whatsoever, ultimately, to not acknowledge anti-whiteism and not do things to help ourselves.